Welcome everyone. I'm Cristina Fumagalli from CIM System Marketing Team. Now I want to introduce you my colleague Christian Borroni. Welcome.
Hello, everybody. Good evening. Welcome to our first webinar from CIM System. We want to show you our software and maybe some way to work some special object, some special work. So today I start with a first overview on our software. And now I start showing our software mailbox. So sorry, it's our first time and we have to test something about all things to do this webinar. So we start with Mailbox. When we started the software the first time, it will show us a little window where we can click on it to this window where we can click on it and this the browser go directly on our web page, where I'll show whether all our news, new application, and so on. You can read here every update that we introduce in our software. And so this is our interface. Very simple, only two bar, right bar, left bar, and all are done a large part of our job are done in automatic by Mailbox. Our philosophy is to try to do all in automatic much as possible, and in case we have all the tools to edit and in case adjust our project. So we can start with a new job. The software proposal as a name of our job, but of course we can introduce our personal job, job name. Is automatic open this right bar, and the software show us how many machine we have in our configuration. Now, of course, I have only a fantasy machine. CIM System. It's possible to select a different toolkit, and of course, it's possible also to create some special toolkit. Maybe we have the necessity to use maybe some tools much longer to do some calls, for example, and we can select fast our right toolkit. Sometimes we have some white screen, so we don't know, maybe it's a problem from the tools used to do this webinar. So we go on. After we choose the right machine, we can start to select the material, and the mailbox show us the different opportunity that we have to mail our job. For each material, it's possible to select a different way, maybe like in this example, a rounded holder, an open holder, or also for titanium, the pre-milled holder to mail our job. So, like for also for other materials. Done in a cubic shape. So we come back in our zirconium material. We can start also with the open holder. And the software go directly inside the folder that we decide to store all our STL. Clicking buying one STL, the software directly show us the shape of the STL in this bidimensional preview. But of course, we can click on it and we have much information about our STL in order to understand which is the right dimension of our stock to sell it in the next step. So one thing important for us is to select the right type of object. This is necessary because different type of object need different point of reference, and this selection give the command at the software to create the right point of reference. This is very important to have the best result and a good way to mill our job. So this is a step to look just 1 minute. After we select, we can confirm our STL. Now the software is analyzing all the features on our object. Millbox is able to work with or without the construction info from different CAD software and create his point of reference. So you see, Millbox recognizing automatically all the margin line, and also in this case, because it's a simple object, the insertion axis of the cavity crown. Go directly on the next step, and we have only to select our right stock. Here in this configuration, it's possible to select a standard zirconium material, and also in this example, the Katana multilayer. The software shows us the number of the user stock that we have in our archive. Now I go to select my 14 thickness stock, in the software in automatic select the much used stock that we have in our list. Okay, now I have only one. But imagine if you have a lot of used stock, this is very helpful to find very fast the much used stock to finish it. And also the software bring the best position following the configuration of the machine and also the features that he recognize on the object. If I want to select this, I can directly confirm or of course I can create a new, and when I go to confirm, now the software asks the right shrinkage factor, the name of the stock, and if I want I can insert also the lot code for recognize our job in the time after time. So we introduce also the possibility to print our label. Is a little code that we can apply glue on the lateral wall of our stock, and we can read this code with our webcam. It's not necessary to buy special hardware and so on, but we can use, of course, our webcam like the hardware to read this code. It's possible, of course, to move our job, and if all is okay for us, we are ready to start our calculation. So you see how is fast ready to start the calculation. This step I will show you in an example. If I want, I can go back to import all the for example, other object, and the meantime, the mailbox are bringing and analyzing my job. I can go all around my folder to bring another STL, and the STL are analyzed in the same time and imported in the same time. Another opportunity that we have with Millbox is to select one job okay, is done an advice. But if maybe I'm in rush with an object, I can select this and start my calculation first on this object. Now, Mailbox are preparing a second section that was open in background, and the calculation start only for this crown. This is our window that show all the options that we can add on the standard strategy in order to increase the quality refining surface on our object. Now, I don't select nothing. I start the calculation, and this is what the software do. The session is background, is going, and we can work, continue our compilation of the project, bringing, moving other STL file, other kind an angled abutment, for example. And meantime, the calculation go on the our full anatomic crown, we can go on with our job in our lab or in our milling center. So just a time that finished the recognition. Sorry for this. We don't understand why with Go webinary this happens. Okay, now I import an abutment much bigger than this stock thickness, and you can see also our focus on the first look that the customer can do on the project. So this is a simple example, but our STL is not possible mill this abutment inside this stock, and the software shows us the red advice. And of course, we can go back to select a bigger one, for example, 22. Okay, but this is another story. I want to show you other things now. Okay, I delete this job. I go to bring another object in crown, and we have this post cutback. I select in this case anatomic, because here I have the anatomy in the occlusal part. The same like before. Okay, and also in this case, maybe I can use another cool tool to mill this object. For example, I can open. Sorry, I select the bad position as possible. But maybe it's better to open another session, because it's possible also open another session, and I go to explain better this kind of exam. Okay, we go on to look just a bit this job that right open. So here we select a multi-layer stock, and it's very useful for a dental technician to look directly on our STL, the changing of the colors, and in this way it can move and rotate our STL file to find the right best position to have the good result after the milling process. Now I go to show exactly this example. Another thing is that, of course, we can do now with Millbox. In the previous version of Summa was not possible. We can go back and we can repeat forever all the steps that we do during the program of Millbox. What we can look on this object, Millbox show us directly all the undercut area present on our object. This is the right example. It's cool because also we can select, looking the undercut area, some special option before starting calculation, but also is very useful when we go to place our connectors on the object, because Millbox update in real time the undercut area. Here, if I place here the connectors here, this zone is full of material, of course. So it's very comfortable have the equator line all around our object. In this way, the strategy is able to clean perfectly all around our connectors. Another cool things that we introduce in Millbox are the rectangular connectors. These connectors are very useful in some special situation. Now I show you an example. Why are very useful? Because these connectors change its shape following the equator line. So in presence of an abutment, like in this case, and the calculation is finished, and remember, we are working on another session. So I can set on the abutment these special connector rectangulars, reduce his thickness 0.5 maybe, reduce 2 millimeter in this way. And now also selecting the connectors, I can set his position right under the margin line. And in this way, I can use my CNC machine like a manual parallelometer. In this way, our machine are able to clean perfectly all around the margin area, and we can mill, for example, okay, it's not his crown, but we can mill in this way, in the same time, the abutment, the personalized abutment, and his crown in the same time. Also, if you have to make the abutment in titanium or cobalt, of course, because these lower sides that bring this type of connectors give us the opportunity to clean perfectly this personalized part. Look also the reference that Millbox understand in automatic, and I speaking about the direction of the personalized part. There is a special operation that follow these degrees and mill perfectly in perpendicularly our personalized part in order to reproduce perfectly his shape. This is a big opportunity. Also, I don't know if you have a telescopic crown. Now, let me check if I have one. Let me check. This is the good things of the live. Okay, so I don't remember where it is. I have too many files. Sorry. So, but you understand me, of course, because you are dental technicians like me. So we can set in this way our rectangular connectors near to the end of the margin line, and Okay, in case we have a telescopic crown here, our job is drawn like the personalized abutment. Of course, we can go back like I say you before. If we move near or too near our object to other one, the software shows us an advice. This is because the roughing area is over the crown. Of course, we can also rotate and in automatic, you see the connectors is attached to the crown. If the connector is in the air, also is flashing the connectors to advise us that it is in the air. And of course, we can also change our connector. We have three kind of connectors: semi-cutable, cutable, and not cutable. Semi-cutable, in the end of the milling process, we have an operation that cut for his 50% his diameter. Cutable, green colors. In the end of the process, the milling process, these connectors will be removed completely. Seems like not put anywhere. So, and this is very useful to don't have some decolorized area after the sintering process when the customer go to refine a little bit the connector side. Maybe you know that zirconium can change and put much light the color. And so our result when we put the ceramic can change. Using these cutable connectors, we can delete this problem because think the machine to refine the surface in the connectors zone. So I hope that you understand with my English. So this is some first some first step that we can do with Milbox. We go on to show you some other tools that we have in the second bar. Here are only some presetted viewing that also we can use our F5, F6, F7, F8, F9 to rotate our stock. With Control A, we can show and hide the holder. With the other some hotkeys, we can show and hide in very fast way some other things like the red cap. Control R, we can hide. So we go on. The second icon shows us some information on our job. The job name, the material, the name of this STL imported, and so on. Here we have the second section, support. You can click here to create a backup of some case to send us to look some problem and try to solve. Here we have the icon to start the TeamViewer session to allow our support to connect with you and manage some project. And here you can click to go directly on our web page to download the last update at disposal for your version. And also here, sometimes when we connect with you, is showed also the license number. Oh my God, tomorrow is ended my license, but I can generate. No problem. Another cool function that we introduce is multi-project calculation. What means? We can select this function, is open this window, And here I'll show with some previous project. So which means you can program many different kinds of project, and you can select your desired project, and you can start a sequential calculation. Maybe, I don't know, you are in the evening, you can create three, four, five project, different project, put an object inside, and after you can start a multi-calculation, select your project by the job management folder. Mailbox, you can go at home, you can go at bar, I don't know, you can continue your works in the lab with other jobs, and Mailbox start your calculation, his calculation in sequence, and when he finishes, you can start in the machine also your job. So, okay, now we go, the calculation is start. We go in a new session because now the calculation is going, and I want to show you Open Job the calculation about the previous crown. Okay, let me go on just a bit on the explanation about these icons. Okay, in job management session window, of course, we can also change the tool set used or select when we start our project from the first icon. Maybe we understand that our upper hole is too long for our kit, toolkit. And we can fast change selecting the useful kit to mill our job in this way. Of course, we can start also a new job from here. Open job, the software go in the folder where we decide to store all the project. And here we have a very big preview, and in a fast way also is possible to search a precise job. And in this way, we can manage in very simple and fast way our job list. So we can also delete maybe some other job, or of course, we can also open the folder with Lab Explorer normal way, or select a job and import the job. In our session. Okay. The last part are a small fast preview where I can go to bring some other object or some other project that I write calculated. Meantime, the background session continues our calculation. So I open another kind of project. Here I want to show you now all in a fast way all other icon. Here there is the icon to open the ISO file, so the CNC file to send in the machine. next icon show us some future, but also we have some shortcut for use this function in a fast way. So, but this is the hide and show icon. Also, the cavity, okay, the cavity direction. Nesting, maybe we can create some confused positioning of our STL. We can say, okay, nest. And we can reorganize our STL position in a fast way. Brush, we can paint some desired area on our job to do some special operation only on the painted area. So after, when I start the calculation, the software shows us some option that will be applied only on the patent zone. If we want to delete some area, we can select this icon, or if we want to delete all the painted zone, we can clean in a fast way in this way. Reusable stock, in this section, we can remove some calculated area, but maybe we don't send in the machine the job. Of course, Mailbox save in automatic the previous position. So if we don't send our job in the machine, we can delete this not used area in this way. We can also export in a manual way our stock and store all this kind of position. Or maybe it's possible to import also from an existing used stock like this, I can select a picture, a good picture. If you look, let me open just a bit just to show you here. Okay, this is a simple cell phone picture. Only we have to set a background color black, if it's possible, to put in evidence the used area. And when we confirm our selection, we can set the diameter, the thickness, and also the shrink effect. We have only to confirm. We can stock we can set the stock name, the lot code, say yes, and just a time that Mailbox create his stock. Okay, this is the result. Okay, our crown are out of the stock. I can select, we control all the crown. With delete, I can remove very fast on my crown, and this is the result. Okay, Mailbox don't bring perfectly because it's from a picture, but look how the area, the useful area, are right recognized from Mailbox, and we can use so with this function our stock maybe use it from a different system. Okay, just a moment, maybe I have a communication. Okay, 30 minutes are done, we go on. Okay, I show you the painted function, but another cool function. Sorry. I show you after in another example. I go on to explain this. Of course, next icon, I can change the shrinkage factor and I can reprint again, print again our label here. The stabilizer, we have a five shape of different stabilizer. Let me open the example. Open job. Of course, I have some example right on full arch. Where is full arch? Here. This is the final example. Okay, full arch. Open. Full arch. I set this job to show you our five different kind of stabilizer. So this is an open stabilizer. I go in order now and select our storic stabilizer. We can set, you see, okay, the connectors after. I can delete and apply better after, or just a move a bit up in this way. Okay, very simple. What is interesting now with our stabilizer? We can move. So with this shape, our stoic shape, there's the lower part is fix it, because maybe you can put in this way, in this position, your full arch in the furnace, and this help to stay up. But what is good, we can move now the center part up and down following our necessity. Okay, we go on with the second one. This is a bigger stabilizer, very big for this example. Is maybe is much useful to use with to use it on a long bridge, but not a full arch. This is another case. But so just to show you that we have it, we go on with the other. And this is the much used stabilizer present in Mailbox. Of course, we can move up and down, but the cool things is this. We can also change his thickness. Maybe I want to put two, but also I can put a negative value to reduce his shape. I click again on the object and the shape of the stabilizer is changing. Following my instruction, I can put the equal material in relationship between the stabilizer and the job. In this way, we can try to compensate the force, the power that are done during the sintering process. Is good to reduce the shape to have the equal. I don't remember in English the equal sides of material in relationship with our job. Okay, we go home. We have another cool stabilizer. This is also useful for a long bridge. A full arch, but is better for me, from my experience, to use only on a long bridge, half full arch, for example. Also here, we can do the changes that we just look on the previous stabilizer. This stabilizer, the open stabilizer, after I show you, what is possible to do with this client. The last one, minus six, I don't know. The last one have this part that is possible manage four or six in order to give space in some area where I can maybe I can apply some undercut operation, and in this way I can give space at the operation to mill this difficult zone. Okay, this is the stabilizer. We have also the opportunity to introduce some STL to use like a personalized stabilizer, maybe for some special material like a sintering metal. Now, I don't have here, I forgot to set the folder, so next time. We go on with the explanation. We can also insert some code here on our job, maybe to recognize when we have in a bigger mini center, maybe we have a lot of job that come out of the furnace. We can being very fast identify the job to put in different box for different client, writing inside, maybe like in this example, inside the cavity ground, customer code, and you can recognize very fast your job. Report, we can create all kind of report, sorry, all kind of report with all person the information that the customer require to have in this report. We can set the thickness of the stock, the lot code, if you want the customer name, all the information that you want. We can prepare a special report in order to have a historic about your job, and maybe bring after time some information about some special case. This is a special icon with many tools that we can use to recreate some point of reference like margin line, or maybe like cylinder axis, to add recap on the holes because we want to close the holes. If we can, maybe we want change the whole dimension, we can increase or reduce it, we can put up, change the axis position, what we want. We can change also the type of the connection if the system recognize an internal abutment like an external. With this icon we can change the situation and put it in the right way. We can also create some curve point of reference around attachment. Let me find here. So we can create these two special curves around our object just to have a special operation all around our attachment in order to create a small bridge like this. You see also the system having the indication of the secondary axis, the curve that I bring before. The curves are created following the attachment direction. And of course, the attachment will be milled with our desired operations. So we can find the secondary axis that are this function showed with this purple arrow. We can add some special area around the emergence area around our abutment. We can, like you see, we can delete some wrong point of reference, maybe. Clicking much than one time, we can hide also some element like the STL or other things, and we can go much easily to delete some things inside our job. We can do also a copy of our STL and maybe mill two times. We can also change a bit the shape of the upper hole on angled abutment. And in the end, we have the dimensional verification using another our software that is able to go in the machine and touch with a special tool our object and make a check in dimensional analyzation between the CAD project. So I'm speaking about a CAD project of a connection and the result in the machine. So this software makes this analyzation, and maybe the users is able to understand if it's needed to repeat some operation to bring the right dimension. So all these functions in the next day of our webinars are much explained better with the specific argument and discussion. Of course, here, in the end, we is possible add some vertical connector, okay? Maybe it was better to show you this connector on the full arch here. Let me delete some function here, some stabilizer, okay. And we can add, of course, the vec connectors also change its shape, maybe. Is better to put conical in this way. You see? And if you need to put in a horizontal position your full arch in the furnace, you can use this connector to maintain the position of the full arch. Let me show you another good function that we have introduced in the last version of Millbox. The function is the custom operation. What I mean, I want to mill this area with a special operation. I can set a personalized operation following my point of view. And you see also Millbox update the shape of our stock and follow our point of view, and the operation will be done following these degrees. If I want to know which operation is applied, I have this button to understand that here is applied a finishing operation with 1 millimeter tool. If I want to add another operation, because for example, this is a a full arch, but is a simple bridge, is not an atomic, but here I have one element, full anatomic, and so I want to add the rest material or the anatomic details with 0.6 millimeter tools. And all the operation in this new color are done with 0.6 millimeter tool. So with this operation, we don't lose time all around our object to use the 0.6 tool, but we save time with this specific selection on our object, and only here the 0.6 operation go. It's also possible, of course, apply in the opposite direction our specific operation. So the time is finished for us. We have only 10 minutes. 1 hour is near to be done. If you have some question about this first introducing, I can answer you with the help of my colleague Cristina. This is the first day. Is a new experience also for us. The tools and the opportunity inside Mailbox are very, very a lot. And I hope in the next day that you follow our next webinar to understand maybe some new way that you maybe don't know, or maybe understand a new way to work some difficult kind of job that we go to speak in the next appointment. So now, with the help of Cristina, if you have some question.
No, for the moment we have no question. There is only one. Thank you, Christian, for your explanation from our client. And now I can give you some information for the next webinar. The registration of this webinar will be available in the next few days. So stay tuned for upcoming events. So you can pick the schedule on our website and social network. And just a second.
Okay.
The recorder will be on a YouTube channel, Chin System Dental. And I think we can share on the group, Mailbox Expert. And when's your next our next webinar? I think will be on the next week. But in a few hours, we can give you the specific schedule and the specific argument. Okay, Christian, I finished. If you want, I can close the webinar. I can give you a huge thank you for your attention, and see you soon.
Okay, thank you all, and see you soon on the next appointment. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.